What's up, school fans? Welcome back to Trash Talk.
Balik bareng gue Ricky Padilla, dan hari ini kita lagi ada di Senayan City. Backgroundnya ada air mancur, dan sebelah gue ada orang yang kita udah lama banget nih gak ketemu, Michael James. Masih pada inget gak nih Michael James? How are you, Mike? Well, what's up, man? Sekarang handshake-nya bener, ini take kedua.
Ini
take kedua, tadi take pertama salah. Mike, how are you, man?
I'm good, bro.
You good?
Yeah.
We haven't seen you di dunia basket in like last time we saw you probably ke Jurnas kali ya.
Itu terakhir sih, itu
Januari tahun 2020 itu dimana dia sama Marcel Bonneville epic battle. Tapi saya Bonneville yang menang tuh.
Yeah, I miss the guy though, honestly.
You miss the guy. Gua no, main banget. Dia kan deket banget sama gua. Lalu juga kayak sering video call sama istri gua, men.
Wait, sama istri lu?
Iya.
I think every girl he'll call, bro.
Yeah,
honestly.
I know, but it's okay though. He's my little brother, so he's fine. Yeah. But Mike, satu setengah tahun terakhir ini lu kayak nggak ngikutin terlalu banyak kompetisi basket banget ya, nggak ikut tanding gitu. Terakhir itu lu juga ada di Impact. Tapi kita mau tahu dong kesibukan lu deh. What you been up to in the last 18 months?
Gua sih sibuk, like I created a couple of my own businesses.
Okay,
that,
wow.
That I want to start up very soon. I already started one. But the one thing that I've been actually doing kayak very okay a lot yeah okay what I did with basketball and how much training I did is what I'm doing now is acting.
Wow, mau jadi actor guys. Michael James berubah arah dia, belok. Tapi sebelum kita ngomongin acting, bisnis dong, boleh di share nggak lagi sekarang lagi mau pursue bisnis apa?
So gue emang lu tau as an actor gue juga main make my own products gitu kan.
Yes.
Bikin my own films, series, whatnot. So gue salah satunya gue lagi bikin PH.
Oh, production house, guys.
Yeah, production house. Kedua, gue lagi juga ngejar bikin F&B, so food and beverage business. I'm not gonna tell you guys what it is. You guys will see. Nanti gue sponsor Rocky.
Yes, yeah. Ditunggu sponsor. Ntar ada logonya di channel ini. Tenang aja.
And then ada beberapa other things that I want to start up juga. Tapi I'm focusing on those two right now.
Okay, so business, F&B, production house, and of course juga lu bilang acting ya. Mm-hmm. Okay, before we talk about acting too. Lu terakhir itu kan main, boleh dibilang di Impact Basketball, right? Orang-orang banyak banget yang suka dead telepon. Gak apa-apa, mau angkat juga gak apa-apa, kita on camera.
That's fine. Nanti lu cut aja.
Oke. Ntar gue cut aja.
Meeting.
Oke, it's okay. Gak gue cut juga gak apa-apa, santai aja. Kok di sini anything goes.
Kan trash talk.
Iya, it's uncut. This is trash talk. Nah. Baik banget yang nanyain gue, actually kayak DM gue nanya Michael James kemana ya kok ya, kok Michael James gak pernah kelihatan lagi. So let us know, man, dari Impact ke Jurnas lalu kenapa menghilang dari basket.
One thing that literally ruined my basketball career was COVID.
Oh, man, I think that thing ruins almost everybody.
No, but this literally like ruined everything. Mm-hmm. So basically kan, yeah, I was having so much fun at Impact.
Yes.
I was playing my ass off there. Did pretty well.
Uh-huh.
And then I got in contact with three schools, yeah.
Yeah, you told me on this channel before,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I got in contact with three schools. And there was one that I really wanted to go to. But then when COVID happened, I was talking, emailing, gitu-gitu kan. Sempat aja I called one of the schools juga, talking to one of the coaches. Terus tiba-tiba, I was trying to get into contact with them again. They stopped talking to me out of nowhere, yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then I was confused. I was like, "What the hell happened?" So I contacted my cousin.
Uh-huh.
My cousin in the States. He plays Division II baseball at that time. Now he's playing Division I.
Wow.
He's taking a master's. He's playing Division I. I asked him. I was like, "Dude, these coaches aren't responding to me." I was like, "Oh, bro, I forgot to tell you. There was a recruiting ban, and coaches are legally not allowed to talk to you."
Jadi pelatih dari Amerika nggak boleh ngomong dengan anak yang internasional kali ya?
Not even internasional, orang-orang yang belum commit.
Oh, oke. Okay.
Misalnya kayak Jalen Green gitu, dia kalau udah commit, pelatihnya masih boleh ngomong sama dia. Tapi kalau orang kayak gue masih baru, mereka masih mau rekrut, nggak boleh.
I see, got it. But how sad were you though? Like, you know, kayak lu nggak bisa pursue your dreams. Your dream kan waktu itu main college basketball
that
kan?
That is like my biggest basketball dream tuh, main college basketball di US.
Iya, terus how sad were you though that you...
Bro, I was heartbroken, bro. Like, gue bener-bener depresi, anjir.
Dang.
I was so sad. Kayak, I did something so well. Like, I tried doing something that banyak orang tuh gak pernah pursue. Kayak, only beberapa orang doang yang ke Amerika. And train, right? Train and actually try to pursue. And I thought that I got a lot better. And you know, to the point yang banyak orang tuh udah nanya-nanya gue kayak, oh lu mau nggak ngobrol sama pelatih ini? Apalagi pelatih gue si David.
Yeah, ini waktu di Impact ya.
Si Impact, he was telling me, as a player, gue punya banyak hope buat lu doang. Cuman mentally lu harus ganti aja mental. That's always been my biggest problem sih, mental. Mental, you know, just my mental dulu kayak jelek juga sih. Kadang-kadang bisa naik, bisa turun kan. Yeah. So like, if I'm confident, gue bener-bener confident banget. Tapi kalau gue turun, gue bener-bener like drop, bro. And skill-wise, menurut gue sih kata dia, he said this, he said skill-wise, I can compete. Cuman masalahnya, size and athleticism.
Of course, size sih selalu jadi problem ya, size
and itu. And lu juga experience bro, those 6'8 guys who can like fly,
but luckily, untungnya gue 182 dan gue mainnya point guard. Jadi gue masih masuk size-nya kalau di sana.
Yeah, tapi kalau dijaga sama orang 6'8 gimana
gua
dong?
Gue udah didang sama Amir Johnson bro.
Oh iya?
Gue didang sama Amir Johnson in my first game in the US. Gue didang sama Amir Johnson.
Gue hampir didang sama Makur Maker sih. Yeah. Untung aja dia miss. Kalau nggak itu highlights di itu.
Kalau gue udah di dalam hati gue udah tenenet, tenenet. Itu kalau ada yang tahu itu lagunya Sports Center di Amerika. Top place. Gue udah mikir dari diri gue udah masuk top place soalnya tadi. Itu telak banget gue. Sosok mau lompat lagi gue mau didang sama Amir Johnson. By the way, nggak tahu Amir Johnson itu bekas main di NBA. Dia dulu salah satu pemain paling top high school di LA waktu gue main. Nah, Mike, di Impact. Di Impact itu waktu itu apakah lu memang harus pulang waktu ada COVID ini atau gimana sih?
Gua kan pulang buat kejurnas, gua izin
oh,
ke mereka.
Oh shit, yeah, that's
gua
right.
Gua izin ke mereka. Gua kayak, hey, I got a big tournament at back home. I wanna play in it because this is my last chance to play a big tournament back home. Gua bilang gitu kan, mereka bilang, oh it's fine, go ahead, just take 2 weeks off. I came a couple days before kejurnas cuma buat latihan sama timnya biar terus to recover jet lag kan. Terus kita mainnya minggu, maybe a week and a couple days.
Yeah, then we just
like 8 days, 9 days, yeah. Like namanya. Yeah, gitu kan. And then the day I was supposed to leave,
there
was literally like blowing up news. Oh, a virus in China has been spreading, and banyak orang di pesawat kena.
Yeah.
Nah, langsung abis itu, when that happened, there's a lot of travel warning gitu.
Yeah.
Orang-orang kayak, hati-hati kalau lu mau travel, hati-hati. Try not to travel now, it's dangerous, gitu-gitu kan. Dan pas itu keluar, kan nobody knew about the virus, right? Nobody knew what it was capable of. And di China at the time, it was killing people already. It was killing people, it was getting a lot of people sick. Terus bokap gue langsung kayak, he was like, you know what, just stay here for another week. Tell them in America, tell them in fact that what's going on right now. Gue bilang, mereka gak apa-apa, just take your time, kata mereka. And then, as days turned to weeks, weeks turned to months.
Yeah, and then
months turned to
years.
Not even going back, bro.
I know, man. It's crazy.
Yeah, I mean, but to be honest with you, if COVID didn't happen, this version of me now would have never existed.
Oh, wow.
Very different version of myself.
Yeah, I'll be probably watching you in the US right now.
Honestly, yeah. Honestly.
Yeah.
I'd probably be a dick in the US, honestly, bro. I'd be like one of them.
Okay, no one being a dick right now. We know what happened. Hot topic. My name is Dipon.
Yeah.
A lot of taunting, a lot of trash talking between. Yang paling seru sih sebenarnya menurut gue Jakarta lawan Jawa Tengah ya. I think that was really fun to watch. Orang netizen banyak banget tapi yang menilai salah tentang apa yang dilakukan sama pemain. And of course terakhir adalah top of the top, Mario Davidson ngedance, shimmy. And then dia dihujat habis-habisan sama netizen. Nah kalau gue, kita sempet ngobrol kemarin ya. Gue tahu lu cerita juga katanya setelah lu ke Jurnas, itu you receive a lot of hate messages on your DMs. Can you just tell us about that story?
Basically, abis kejurnas, like you know, like you were there firsthand experiencing. Yeah. You can't tell highlights from games.
Yes.
You can't. You really can't tell the difference between a highlight. You can't tell the difference between a real game and a highlight. Yeah. Look on the highlights. You only see the good stuff.
Yes.
When I play against Jawa Timur,
in the finals.
Lu lihat mereka jaga gue triple team box one anjir. You're like, yeah. How can I, like, bro, like, mereka defense-nya udah bagus banget kan?
Yeah.
Dan itu bikin gue capek juga, anjir. Yeah. Like, I can't even get the ball. They're playing really good defense. I would ask Aji, Jalu, gitu-gitu buat screens.
Yeah.
Gue keluar, mereka switch langsung box one gue lagi. Like, emang gue gak capek?
Yeah.
Gue capek banget, anjir.
Yeah.
But then, padahal throughout the Jurnas, I was playing very well. Like, gue lawan Jabar, I went off like, shit, bro. I was destroying them.
Yeah.
Terus lawan Jateng, gue juga main bagus. I had a double-double against Jateng.
Oh,
and then,
shit.
Against Banten, I played well. I didn't play against what was that team? Bengkulu.
I think so. Because you guys crushed them, bro.
No, we didn't.
Oh, you didn't?
No, we didn't. We played. Our team played so bad. Tapi gue nggak main. Karena gue minta, gue bilang ke coach Pram, I got injured. I got injured in my second game. I thought, gue pas lawan Jatim in the fourth quarter, I slipped and then I did a split and then my groin was just in pain. So abis itu gue langsung gue bilang aja, hey coach, I don't think I play next game. Let me rest. I want to prepare for the next games. It helped. Tapi gue masih mainnya masih cedera.
Okay.
So I wasn't able to play. I was probably playing at like 70% capability. I wasn't able to jump as high. I wasn't able to run as much. Jadi beban banget buat gue. Dan that hit me mentally, bro.
Mentally
hit me. And physically sih, obviously. Like, I couldn't run as much, right?
Yeah. What I'm trying to do right now in Indonesia is spread awareness about mental health. Because, ya gue paling worry sih kayak Mario Davidson gitu, gue takutnya dia malah gak mau main basket lagi gitu loh.
That's true. And back to the topic yang kita ngomongin. Pas gue lawan Jatim, abis itu gue langsung dapat hate messages banyak banget. And
like what though? What were they saying?
They were saying like, bro, why'd you go to the US? Like it's not, like lu jadi, lu tambah jelek main di US. Like, people don't understand how fucking hard it is to play in the US, man.
Yeah, it is.
Imagine being my height, 5'9", play against a bunch of black guys who are 6'10" and can fly.
Yeah.
Like, can you guys like not understand that? Like, it's hard, bro. Like, even Derek, who's playing in Australia, he's 6'9". But like, he's not playing as if he's Giannis. He's not. There's so many skilled players over there, man. Like, lu juga kayak fucking Amari Bailey? Damn, bro.
Amari Bailey so good. Tapi orang Indonesia belum siap tuh ngomongin Amari Bailey. Like, dia kok tauntingnya pegang biji. Pegang biji terus ke keluarga lawannya. Itu kalau di Indonesia udah tawuran, guys. Udah tawuran pasti. Gak mungkin enggak itu kalau di Indonesia. Tapi emang di Amerika, ya kita first hand, kita punya experience first hand sih. Menurut gue, di Amerika itu lumayan parah sih. Trash talking,
bukan
counting.
Lumayan, anjir. It's so bad.
And it's kind of disrespectful.
It's so disrespectful.
Yes,
it's
kinda.
So disrespectful, bro.
So if you don't have strong, if you're not strong mentally, lu gak akan bisa survive karena orang Amerika, they just don't take it personally, aja sih. Menurut gue ya.
Yeah, like bro, literally gue kayak, okay, gue cerita ke lu ya.
Yeah.
Gue pas lawan Hillcrest Prep, and you know they were one of the best teams here at the time, right? Gue harus jaga Dalen Terry.
Oh,
do you know Dalen Terry?
I think I watched him in Seattle.
He plays in
Arizona,
UFA.
Right?
Yeah,
Arizona. Yeah,
he's a pointer of UFA now.
Yeah,
I had to guard him. Yeah, gue jaga dia. Uh-huh. Terus gue mainnya keras banget. Uh-huh. Tapi gue main kerasnya kayak I was playing as if I was Campazzo. Lu tau kan kalau Campazzo main defense dia kayak benar-benar harass the guy, gue gitu kan. Terus the guy was just like talking so much shit to me gitu-gitu kan. I wasn't letting him get the ball gitu-gitu sampai dia kayak dia sampai bete kan. Dan pas dia mulai bete, dia mulai ngomong-ngomong ke gue kayak, hey little bitch, get out of my way, you fucking bitch, dorong-dorong gue gitu-gitu.
Little
terus
bitch.
Terus gue langsung kayak I was, cause gue udah experience kan, gue udah dibacot-bacotin sama orang, so I was already used to that shit, right? Terus gue ngomong, I'm like, yo, you D1 guy, you can't score on me, come on, gitu-gitu. Di situ, sejak dia after the game, he still scored a lot on me. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, the guy is still a good player, and he's like 6'6", and he plays a point guard position.
Yeah.
Of course, he still scored on me, but I still tried my best to guard him. After the game, gue nggak mau ngomong sama dia. Gue kira dia bete sama gue. Came up to me, yo little man, keep up the hard work, man. If you keep doing that, you know you're gonna be somebody. Gitu-gitu.
I mean, at the end of the day, it's all about respect.
It's all about respect, and I think dari matanya dia, I earned my respect. And in America, you have to earn respect. You can't ask for it.
It
is very hard to earn respect.
Yeah, di Amerika harus earn respect sih. Kenapa ini nggak fokus ya? Semoga fokus habis ini. Semoga videonya fokus nih, gara-gara ada air kali jadi dia nggak fokus ya.
Yeah, mungkin itu deh. Terus lightnya?
Lightnya kali ya. Oke. Kita semoga fokus. Tapi apa? Dalen kemarin main di tempatnya Jamal Crawford juga dia. Main di situ gue nonton. Dia ngedang lewat kolong sih, ngedang sih agak gila sih. But in the USA, seperti gue bilang, orang-orang main-main itu they don't take it personal, they just show mereka malah nunjukinnya dengan game mereka sih, mereka balasnya itu dengan game mereka, nggak dengan apa ya, dengan ngajakin berantem atau apa gitu. And at the end of the day, kalau lu memang bisa ngambil respectnya mereka dengan ngelawan dan juga main bagus, pasti dia akan say their respect. Dan itu yang gue mau ini sih di Indonesia mau gue pengen kayak kasih tahu juga lah, kayak orang tuh don't take it personally, man. Dan semua tuh leave it on the floor.
Yeah, leave it on the floor. You know. The thing is, here's the thing about orang-orang di Amerika. Yeah. They can be dickheads on the court.
Yeah.
Tapi off the court, mereka pasti bisa baik orangnya.
Baik.
Lu nggak tahu, bisa aja mereka juga dickhead. Tapi like, it's on the court. What's on the court, leave it on the court. Jangan, don't take it personally.
Yes, that's what I'm saying too. Dan kalau menurut lu ya, lu ngeliat Mario gitu ngedance after scoring, What do you think?
Bro, let him, bro. Like, what? Justru ya, I was happy seeing him do that.
Yeah.
Because you know why? One, he was trying to build. You can tell, he has swagger. Obviously, he's always had swagger. Tapi yang bikin itu menurut gua bagus is that look, kalau dia kayak gitu kelihatan mentalnya it's kuat.
Yeah.
His mental capability is strong. Dan dia juga pede pas itu. You know, if someone dances like Steph,
yeah,
bro, man, guy's still dancing like crazy, right? Terus
kemarin dia Jordan Poole 3 point.
Yeah.
Itu juga dia ngedance bola juga belum masuk itu di bench.
Iya yeah, kan? And then gue lihat dia kan. Gue lihat, I was like, yeah, you know what? That's good. Go ahead and dance. Because it builds your confidence up.
Yeah.
Not only that, if your teammates see you do that, mereka confidence-nya makin naik juga.
True.
And that's what he was trying to do. He was trying to build his team, you know, trying to build his team spirit biar mereka menang kan. Of course, he's a fighter. He wants to win. So like that's one thing that I think should be looked at again sebagai pemain-pemain basket di sini or even basketball fans. Kayak,
I know, right?
Like,
I'm so mad it's not going to be focused. Okay, setengah jalan mukanya buram kali itu gue rasa tadi. Hey, hopefully not too bad. Tapi apa namanya? Yeah, man, gue juga sedih aja sih ngeliat orang. I don't know, man, attacking him, trying to put him down, because he was just enjoying his time. Kita hidup cuma sekali. We only live once, and kita main basket because we love the game.
Yeah, exactly. Like, here's the thing about basketball. Like, it's a fun game.
Yeah.
And kalau lu main basket tapi you don't have fun, what's the use of playing it? We all started playing basketball because it's fun. We like the game. I fell in love with the game because I thought it was fun.
Yeah.
I fell in love with the game. I thought it was fun. I wanted to be better. And if you think you can make the game more fun for even just the fans, go ahead.
Yeah, the fans.
It's better. It makes it more entertaining. Lu kalau lihat mereka trash talk gitu, lu entertain gak?
Entertain banget, gila. Gua senyum-senyum sendiri kok pas nonton Jateng lawan Jakarta. I was smiling when I was watching. Because I thought this is basketball. Lu nggak mau main nonton basket yang game-nya flat lah.
Ya, kayak lu lihat gua pas lawan Jatim, gua ngomong terus lawan Marcel. Ya, gua kalah nggak apa-apa. Tapi gua juga mau. I wanna be at a way where you can't get in my head, you know.
And what was about to say ya? Oh, we are all human.
Yeah.
We're all human. Kita semua punya emotion. Kita nggak mungkin nggak show our emotion on the court. So I think that's the biggest message. Kita semua masih manusia kok. Semua itu punya emosi. Pasti punya. Kalau kita 3-point, 4-point play, pasti seneng. Mm-hmm. You know. So we just that's one way we express our happiness aja sih on the court mode gue sih.
And what happened with Mario abis dia kalah? If he won, it would have been a different story.
Yeah,
no one would have done that.
Yeah,
tapi true. Karena dia kalah, banyak orang tuh, they said a lot of bad things about him. And personally speaking, gue kayak, I was sad to look at that. Karena kayak, again, as you said, he's human and he has feelings, you know, like, what if that much hatred got into him sampai dia gak main basket?
That's what I was scared of. I was scared of that.
Yeah, like, that's one thing about basketball here, yeah, kayak, banyak orang tuh nggak main basket karena mereka nggak suka what happens to them if they don't do good. Kan there's like so much expectations like pas gue balik gue dari Amerika, did people think I was gonna be like Michael Jordan? Hell no.
That's what happened to me though.
Oh, yeah.
That's what happened to me. Everybody thought I was gonna be the next Mario Busang.
Yeah, exactly. Like you gotta understand that basketball isn't always so easy. Especially if you want to pursue your game at a way higher level. Not easy, bro. I had to work my ass off in America. Like, lu harus tahu ya, gue pulang bisa tidur langsung anjiran. Gue pulangnya jam 6 sore ya.
Iya.
Gue pulang jam 6, gue langsung tidur. Gue capek, tepar. Gue terus tidur the whole night. Like, sampai pagi ya gue tidurnya.
I can't imagine that, though.
It's tiring, bro. Like,
damn, I have one question that I forget. I'm trying to remember. That's why I'm, like, looking at the camera, too. Damn, I have one question that I want to ask you and I forgot about it. Okay, so we move on, lah. We move on to acting. Is this now gonna be your next move?
Yeah, it is. It's dari kecil sih, gue passionnya acting all the time. I've always loved watching movies. It's not about the money for me.
Okay.
It's about the art. Gue bener-bener cinta banget sama artnya acting. And I wanna be good at that because something that dari gue kecil emang gue pengen kan. Dan menurut gue sih, my best chance kalau mulai sekarang.
Okay.
Karena apalagi gue nggak sibuk basket kan, I'm not busy with basketball. It's the best time for me to start. Dan gue tipenya orang kalau gue punya passion, I'll go 1000% with it, bro.
Okay.
Gue dari kemarin acting class bisa hampir tiap hari gue ikut acting class gitu-gitu, ikut acting class. Terus I'm not gonna tell what I told you there, you know, that's secret between us, right? But Yeah, pokoknya emang it's the art that I really like, and I just want to be good at it. You know, money will come. For me, money will
of
come.
Of course.
Money will come, regardless.
Uh-huh.
But it's about, you know, just having the opportunity to do something that I love doing. And gue dari kecil emang pengen jadi actor. It's just that I never talked about it with people. Karena gue mikirnya kayak orang-orang bakal kayak, ah apaan sih lo baik jadi actor? Kayak gue takutnya gitu, gue insecure banget dari dulu, dari kecil kan. So like, and then I realized, I was like, I have so many friends in like the film industry. I was like, dude, why the fuck not? I'll go for it.
Yeah.
You know? So I did. And like, that's what I'm doing now. I'm trying to pursue that passion. Itu aja.
Siapa role model lo kalau untuk acting?
Bro, you shouldn't ask me that question. Gue banyak banget, anjir.
Give me one at least so we know. Kayak lu siapa sih yang inspire lu to be an actor?
It depends, karena gue banyak banget orang-orang yang different type of acting. You know what I mean? Like, there's different types of acting that I like. Like acting
I
style.
Love Kevin Hart. I like The Rock. I think The Rock is solid.
Yeah. Tapi like, the people that I watch aren't like them, not like them. Gue bener-bener kayak pure actors.
Yang kita gak kenal nih pasti nih. Yang kita
no, pasti lo kenal kok. A lot of the people that inspired me were the characters from Game of Thrones.
Gue gak nonton Game of Thrones.
Pokoknya mereka actingnya gila-gila banget sih. And then there's a lot of Netflix shows that I've been watching, that I've been learning, trying to learn from them. Gitu-gitu, lihat aja mereka acting style-nya kayak gimana. A lot of them. I've been watching international shows juga. Gue nonton apa, Money Heist, gue nonton Dark.
Squid Games.
I haven't watched that. Oh my god.
Gue
udah kena spoiler berapa kali, anjir.
Gue udah pernah nonton juga Squid Games.
Gue harus nonton, anjir, itu Squid Games.
It's Squid Game. Number one.
It's the number one show on Netflix right now, man.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. And then, just like a lot of movies. Gue dari kemarin nonton a lot of classics. Gue nonton Casablanca. Gue nonton.
Damn.
12 Angry Men.
Itu untuk lu belajar aja ya. Belajar.
I want to see how the difference between, you know, film noir, films in the 80s, films now, how they were shot at, how they were like, you know, created. Gitu-gitu aja sih. And personally, like nowadays, one of my favorite actors, Michael B. Jordan.
Oh yeah, Michael B. Jordan. He's cool though. He's really cool. He played me on apa film yang tinju? Creed. Rocky.
Damn.
Rocky Balboa, right? I think that's Rocky Balboa.
I can't wait to see a black Rocky Padilla.
Yeah, that's gonna be in a while. But acting, right? From student of the game to student of film. Bener gak?
Bener.
And now, lo kalau ada acting gini, apakah lo 100% you gonna be, lo kayak mau kasih semuanya, apakah lo masih open up? Karena gue tahu lo ada satu tim IBL nih. Ada satu tim IBL yang kayak, ayolah Mike, main lah sama kita lah. You know, we want you on our team. Itu bikin lo tergoda gak sih?
Pasti.
Terus gimana tuh?
Yeah, well I'm doing a lot right now, right?
Uh-huh.
So 95% chance right now gue bener-bener belum bisa.
Okay.
And karena kan gue lagi pursuing acting like 100% right now. Tapi at the same time, you know, gue juga mikir-mikir kayak I don't want to have regrets with my life. Kayak pokoknya gue misalnya ke gue umur 30, I don't want to look back and like think to myself kayak fuck, I should have done this.
I know.
When I had the chance, you know. Mm-hmm. So main basket masih iya, kayak I'm still thinking about it. It's just right now I don't have the time. Bener-bener, gue gak ada waktu sama sekali. Apalagi gue schedule meeting sama lu, gue juga bilang, hey Rock, gue sibuk hari ini, cuman hari ini doang sama jam ini doang gue bisa. Gitu-gitu kan kalau lu.
Untung gue orangnya fleksibel.
Makanya gue kayak, alright, we can do that then, right? Abis ini aja gue mau kerja.
Iya, abis ini mau meeting. Gue sih pulang abis ini, edit video.
And then, pokoknya right now gue bener-bener like focused on just acting and like, you know, the things that I'm starting up.
Yeah.
Like, kalau lu kan lu bener-bener passionate about YouTube.
Yeah, I'm passionate about basketball.
Basketball, and and you know, like you want to show your fans get together. Yeah. Right? You want to, you know, raise awareness about basketball everywhere.
About basketball, but you know, I want to highlight kids. I think anak-anak di Indonesia, goal gue tetap adalah menemukan bintang-bintang basket baru. Don't forget guys, Derek dari channel ini juga loh.
Kayaknya gue juga deh.
Oh, Michael Jordan juga dari sini. Marcel Bonfil juga dari sini juga gitu, tapi enggak.
Ini semua orang deh.
Tapi passion gue adalah untuk menemukan bintang-bintang basket baru sih.
And you know what? Gue appreciate lu banget for what you did.
Thank you so much, man.
Like, if it wasn't for you, do you think Derek would be in Australia right now? if it wasn't for you, do you think Dede would be, you know, as successful as it is now?
I wouldn't take all the credits because they have to put the work in too. But I think my channel helps a little bit.
I think it more than a little
bit.
Like,
but I still respect them because they put in
course,
the work.
Of course, those guys, I have the utmost respect for Derek, Dede, all those guys who work their ass off to play. You know, like those guys, I have the utmost respect. Like they're pursuing their passion. You got, I always love looking at people pursuing their passion. Like it's just, you know, it's something that they want to do with their life.
Yeah.
It's something that they love. And you know what? I have the utmost respect for people who all want to go do what they're passionate about. You know, if you're trying to go for basketball, go for it. You know, no one's stopping you.
Maybe your parents, but
maybe.
I mean, if they're not stopping you, then go for it, bro. Like gue dulu emang bokap gue kayaknya nggak setuju sama gue jadi actor, right? But then he saw that I was very passionate about it, and he knew. Karena pas nih gue cerita about how I started basketball. Basically, gue ke Amerika kan, I go there every year.
I know the story.
I told you, I'm just telling them. Gue every year kan gue ke Amerika. Gue kan all my family members live there. Gue cuma bokap gue sama gue di sini kan. All my family members tinggalnya di sana. Terus gue nonton Golden State.
I know.
Gue nonton Golden State satu game, Warriors against Clippers, 2012 or 13, I forgot. Tapi pokoknya tahun itu mereka kalah lawan Clippers.
I see.
Mereka tahun itu kalah lawan Clippers. Game 7.
Okay.
2013 December. Okay, 2013 December. Gue inget. 2013 December gue nonton kan. Nah, pas itu gue masih main bola pas itu. Gue masih main soccer. Terus, I watched Steph Curry for the first time in my life.
Oh man.
Bro, that guy like opened up my heart to basketball. After the game, gue langsung gue ke Golden State Warriors store.
Beli jersey.
Gue ambil jersey, Christmas jerseynya mereka. That was the first jersey I've had.
Okay.
Christmas jersey, Steph Curry number 30. Kan dulu mereka bikin Christmas edition jerseys
every,
kan.
Every year.
Gue beli, gue bilang bokap gue, can I buy this? He was like, fine, you can buy it, but you have to play basketball. Udah, gas, gue main basket. Gue pulang ke Jakarta. Gue langsung main basket, gue mulai. I gave up soccer completely 100%.
Gue yakin dari banyak banget sih yang dirubah hidupnya sama Steph Curry sih. Gue yakin banyak banget.
One of the most influential players of our of our generation.
Iya, generasi lu lah ya, ngomongin generasi lu lah.
Kalau
gue masih Kobe. Kalau gue masih Kobe. Kalau Kobe, of course gue itu yang menginspirasi semua lah. Tapi kadang lu kayak liat Derek ya. Lu kayak seberapa seneng sih liat Derek, gila. Getting closer, man. I think getting closer to go to D1, man.
Gue seneng banget sama Derek, cause like I've actually seen a couple of his games.
Okay.
On YouTube, it's on YouTube if you guys wanna watch it.
Like, I haven't seen it yet, but I heard he's playing really well.
He's playing well. It's not like superstar level, he's scoring 20 points, but he's contributing to his team. He's playing well, he's scoring 10 points, getting boards. And one thing yang gue suka banget dari Derek, he still hustles for rebounds, bro. Gila! The guy gue kayak lihat lari masuk. Even though he's like on the 3-point line, someone shoots, he's running in. Itu yang gue respect dari Derek, cause the guy still works his butt off, man.
Yeah.
Gue gak mau ketawa, like, if people start talking shit about Derek, that's when this whole thing is gonna be over.
They already started.
I mean, they said Filipinos,
like, yeah, they said like Derek doing too much TikTok. I told Derek like, bro, dong, gak usah dengerin.
Yeah, gak usah, you know, do what you wanna do. Yeah.
Kalau lu suka main TikTok, lu main TikTok aja gak apa-apa, that's emangnya gak ganggu latihan lu gitu loh. Emangnya gak ganggu latihan lu, gak ganggu fokus lu. It's okay gitu.
Gue setuju banget sama itu karena kayak what else? He was only doing a lot of that when he was in quarantine, right?
Yeah.
What the fuck was I doing in quarantine? Nothing, bro. I was stressed as shit. Makanya gue kadang-kadang Der, lu ngapain, gue ke rumah lu ya bikin TikTok yuk, gue gabut gitu aja gue.
Yeah, I think people sometimes terlalu menilai dia kayak, oh iya dia gak pernah latihan tuh cuma TikTokan doang gitu. Well, dia behind closed door gila banget.
Iya emang, like
put in the work.
He's like me, bro. Pas gue di Impact, didn't see any didn't see shit from me, right? Like for the 6 months I was there, he didn't see shit from me. I did that on purpose because buat apa orang-orang tahu lu latihan keras terus?
Yeah.
Yang penting lu jadi you yourself have to be a better player.
True.
And gue menurut gue, I did become a better player. I learned so much from the players there, bro. Like, and a lot of them said that I actually was a good player. Like I was still able to shoot well. I was still able to compete with my jump shot. Karena like I'm confident enough that I'm a good shooter.
Yeah.
I can shoot the ball
you
well.
Have to.
Yeah. Kan? That's the thing with a lot of people. Like banyak orang tuh mereka mikirnya mereka kayak enggak. They know they're good but they don't want to say it.
Yeah.
That's not good, bro. Like menurut gue, like bro, if you're good, just fucking say it, man.
Like, gotta keep it humble, bro.
You gotta keep it humble, but at the same time, you know, if someone says you're good, just say thank you. I appreciate that.
Yeah, of course.
Kalau enggak, like if someone says you suck, I'm like, nah, bro, come on. Gitu aja, you know.
Come on, man, you gotta,
you gotta talk to me like that. You want me to bust you, gitu.
But tapi di sekarang ini di Indonesia ini, gue pengen create a culture di mana kita saling support lah. You know?
Yeah. Too much hate. Yeah. Way too much hate.
Yes. Yeah.
It's like they're trying to bring someone down, you know.
Yeah. That's what they like to do.
Yeah.
Tapi gue pengen banget create culture di mana kita saling support. you know, show love. Like,
just show love. Yeah. Man. Like, just even kalau ada orang, like, a lot of people are still doing that. But at the same time, banyak juga orang-orang kayak lagi, you know, bringing Mario down. You know, I mean, like, I saw a lot of his messages. I just wanted to see what people are saying about him. Jujur aja, bro, that shit made me sad, bro. Like,
I know. When I saw it, I posted something on my story, and
I reposted that thing.
Yeah, you reposted, and gue langsung juga reach out ke Mario secara personal.
I also talked to him. I was like, bro, don't listen to those guys, man. Just listen to yourself. You're a fucking good player.
Yeah.
And you should know that you're a fucking good player. Gue bilang itu ke dia.
Gue cuma bilang, keep having fun, bro. Yeah, keep having fun, man. You know, just be yourself. Don't change yourself. But yeah,
like here's the thing. Look at Steph Curry. Steph Curry scores 50 points a game, dances like a white girl, and still he can still lose.
Yeah.
Cuman kayak, do you think people bring him down? No. Like, people support him because of how good he is as a player. Like,
yeah.
Gue juga pengen punya culture where kita lebih support orang-orang daripada bring him down. Kayak kalau ada orang mainnya jelek ya support him. Like, don't say you stop.
Orang mainnya jelek pasti udah biasa lah. Orang tapi main nggak mungkin main bagus setiap game, anjir.
Iya loh. Like, dude, not everyone has a good game, man. Like, not everyone can play consistently. You know what I mean? Like. Okay, except Michael Jordan, but like, you know, other than that, even Kobe's had some bad games. LeBron, bro, there's one game he had 8 points in the playoffs, right? Like, dude, a guy like LeBron can play bad?
I mean,
for LeBron it's a different story. A lot of people gave him shit for it. Like, even personally, I don't like LeBron. I respect him. He's such a
LeBron
fucking
gila,
player. I just don't like him as a player, like, because I'm a Golden State Warriors dude, alright?
I mean, like, LeBron getting hit every day, probably.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you're used to it, probably. You don't even care now.
Yeah, I don't like LeBron. Like, honestly, I don't like LeBron, but I respect him. He's a good player, but I don't like him. I really don't like him.
Like, he's a billionaire.
He's a billionaire. He shouldn't care. Exactly.
Yeah, he doesn't care.
Exactly, like, bro, he's getting all this hate, but he has $1 billion. Bro, the guy can just retire right now and live his life and, like,
I know.
Like, bro. Gila sih, like, LeBron ya kan?
Tapi emang di Indonesia itu, ya gue tau lah, gue gak bisa jadi pahlawannya lah, atau gak bisa jadi hero-nya for changing the culture. Tapi at least gue bisa membantu dikit lah. Gue mau spread love, man. Ya gue appreciate lah, banyak banget pemain dari PON, pemain dari DBL, pemain semua reach out ke gue bilang thank you, udah diliput, thank you untuk efforts-nya. Itu menurut gue tuh hal yang, wow, dulu jarang loh. Maksudnya gue dulu jujurnya jarang loh ada pemain yang kayak DM me like personally atau WhatsApp ataupun juga komen bilang kayak gitu. Mungkin ada beberapa, tapi nggak sebanyak sekarang. Sekarang itu gue lihat anak-anak ini, wow, luar biasa banget sih mereka sih.
They kinda do that with you all the time. Every time I ngobrol ke lu, kayak, hey, dude, I appreciate what you're doing, bro.
Yeah,
like, you're doing something crazy. You know,
I said not a lot of players, Mike.
Exactly.
I said a few.
Now, I mean, like, a lot of people are doing that karena they finally like realize how hard you have to work. Karena kan lu bolak balik US, US Indo, US.
Mereka udah mulai lihat efforts gue sih sekarang ini sih, you know. Mike Tits setengah jam anjir.
Ya enggak apa-apa lah.
Setengah jam anjir.
Tapi ya again,
but this is good though.
Yeah.
This is good content dan menurut gue banyak sekali pelajaran yang bisa diambil dari sini. Ya hopefully juga membuka apa ya, pikiran banyak orang sih.
Yeah, again, like, gue cinta banget sama Indonesia and the fans because a lot of the fans, you know, they support us so much. Tapi at the same time, like, kita semuanya, we all have feelings, you know, we all have emotions. And with what people did to Mario, you know, you shouldn't. I'm just like saying, just don't do that. Like, you know, if he had a bad game, he had a bad game. But if he loses, but the thing is, like, he didn't have a bad game. He actually played well.
He played well. Tapi the next game he played bad.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe because of what happened.
I think so. I think itu ganggu banget. Pasti dia ganggu banget sama itu.
And like,
but I told him to stay up, man. Just stay up, man. You know,
like, for anyone who's experienced like people saying shit about you, saying like bad things about you, you know, just don't listen to them. What you should listen to is the person that's actually training you. Okay, misalnya, if your coach tells you you're doing bad, that's when you actually have to listen to him. Like, but your coach won't like say like, bro, you suck, you piece of shit. Nah, bro, like, come on, man, what kind of coach would do that? Actually, never mind. Di sini banyak sih.
Banyak sih.
Cuman kayak, you know, you gotta listen to him because that's when you're making a mistake. But if other people from an external factor are saying that, like, don't take it to heart.
Yeah,
don't take it personally.
Heart.
You know, like
itu yang gue pelajarin di Amerika sih.
Don't take it to heart.
Yeah. Never take anything personally. Karena kalau lo take it personally, udah lo akan down pasti.
Kayaknya mungkin orang-orang nggak suka lihat Mario gitu karena mereka kayak, oh, you should still be humble, kayak gitu.
Ya, pada bilang sombong. Dan pada mungkin pada bilang, oh, lu kalah juga, ngapain gaya-gaya, banyak gaya lu gitu.
Yeah, tapi mereka nggak ngerti kenapa he did that.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of factors why he did that. Boosting confidence, boosting his teammates.
Teammates
confidence,
gitu. Confidence.
And then he wants to, you know, show for the fans, bro. Like, Yesiah, my God, the guy is such a showcaser, man. Like, the guy, lu lihat dari matanya Yesiah, the guy is having so much fun when he plays.
He is having so much fun.
Yeah, I still remember when I was watching that game, Gading Muna versus Fielders.
bro, he was talking so much shit to the entire team. He still lost.
Yeah.
But dude, the guy was like, bro, go impressed.
He was killing.
He was killing the shit out of him. Nobody could guard him.
Yeah.
Until he dia kram. Then
nggak bisa
main lagi.
Sampai dia kram itu.
Hampir dia kram udah.
Kalau dia nggak kram, beda cerita.
Menang sih kayaknya mereka.
Ronald juga kram soal waktu itu. Kalau Ronald nggak kram juga beda cerita.
Saya was torching them, bro. Gila. He was torching them.
And he was itu ya saya abis weightlifting sama UPH.
Iya.
Lu bayangin gak kalau dia gak weightlifting paginya? Gak akan kram itu. Gak akan kram kalau dia gak weightlifting itu.
Iya. And like, you know, that's also a lot of the factors that need to be talked about. Karena kan, ya, then again, gua tuh, again, I love the fans here. That's one thing that makes, you know, why people, that's one thing that makes basketball great are the fans here. The fans here, because of how much basketball has grown here, banyak banget fansnya sekarang kan?
Iya.
Like, I didn't know how big basketball was until I started playing it again here, ya. Gua mainnya pas kelas 9, that's when I first started playing basketball. But again, kita pemain-pemain semuanya punya perasaan sendiri. Dan menurut gua, just don't taunt them so much, man. Pas, when I got taunted, like, that got to my head, bro.
You got into your head,
that got into my head. And like, would you do, I didn't play ball for like a month because of that, bro. That shit made me fucking sad, like.
You know? I'm like, yeah, it's crazy, you know. Kadang-kadang orang kan pakai akun palsu kan.
Emang itu yang bikin gue capek juga ya orang-orang pakai akun palsu. Gue pengen tahu siapa aja nih orang-orang kayak.
Kita bisa cari kok ada cyber police kan.
Tanya aja, like you can go text Derek, text Marcel. If you text them, they'll probably say like, yeah, it got to me a couple times. But
of course.
But like, you know, still stay strong. Like gue sekarang.
Yeah, stay strong.
Yeah, like I told you, like gue dari kemarin been training with Tony.
Yeah.
Guy talks the most shit in the world.
But Anthony Cates, guys. Anthony Cates.
He's my homie, but he's the biggest dick in the world. Screw you, Tony. Fuck you. All right. But I love you, Tony. And then, but the guy talks so much shit.
Yeah.
But he does that on purpose because he wants me to work on my, you know, he wants me to work mentally, like be stronger. Dan dari itu, yeah, like it's work.
Yeah.
Pertama kali gue main lawan dia, the first few months. Guy got in my head so many times. Sampai gue bener-bener sedih kayak gitu. Yeah. You talk so much shit, you can't guard me, you fucking trash. Now when he does that, gue cuma senyum-senyumnya aja.
Ketawa.
Let my game show. Yeah, you know? Yeah. Like, yeah, I talk back sometimes. But at the same time, you know.
Semua itu disenyumin aja.
Yeah, senyumin aja. The most, like the biggest trash talk you can do is if someone's giving you shit and you just stay quiet.
Yeah. Pokoknya, stay quiet and you kill the guy on
just
the court.
Just destroy the guy on the court.
Yeah, kan? Pokoknya as long, pokoknya kalau trash talk itu gue juga sebenarnya gak mempromosikan trash talk yang gimana-gimana banget. Yang
gue penting, juga, don't be like Americans, bro. That's another level.
Yeah, that's another level. Kok kayak American tuh another level. Cuma maksud gue as long gak personal, gak ngomongin keluarga, atau gak ngomongin yang...
Like Mary gimana. Bailey with his balls too.
Yeah, with...
Di situ langsung tawuran, itu dikebukin. Jadi kayak 10 orang langsung bukin dia.
Keluarganya, tapi keluarga lawannya santai doang, ketawa-tawa doang keluarganya.
And it's normal for them.
Yeah, normal for them. Because it's the culture.
Yeah. And then like... Again, like, lu liat gue trash talk sama Marcel, we always talk smack. But you know, we're best friends. The guy's my homie, bro. I love the guy. Love the guy to death. But I talk so much shit to him because, yeah, that's just us, bro. Like, this is our friendship, kayak, you know? Like, shout out to Marcel for not being... Okay, dia baperan kadang-kadang sih. Dan gue juga, I also say sorry when dia kebaperan. Tapi kayak, like, we talk so much shit to each other because we wanna put on a show.
Yeah.
Dan, like,
that's the biggest thing.
Yeah, we wanna entertain the fans, you know? Like one thing about basketball, lu kalau nonton basket pasti lu nggak mau bosen juga kan?
Iyalah.
You wanna have some fun, like
pasti lah.
You wanna have some fun dan menurut gua, the culture should be more appreciative of people trying to have fun, trying to you know make the game more enjoyable.
Mereka harus ngerti sih, you know, mereka harus ngerti bahwa ini all the players just having fun, having
the
time
of
their life.
Just having fun, like kadang-kadang sometimes they might be doing it too much.
Yeah,
sometimes.
Maybe. Tapi nggak apa-apa, maksud gua kan, fun itu. Mereka cuma ikut biasanya sekali doang misalnya gitu.
Iya lah, all of those guys cuma bisa sekali.
Iya, makanya.
It's every 4 years kan.
Yeah.
So like, let you know what? This one was one of the most competitive tournaments I've
ever
seen.
One of the most competitive, yes.
It was so fun for me to watch. Apalagi Sulsel. Shout out to Sulsel, man. Those guys played their asses off.
Sulut.
Sulsel anjing.
Sulsel cewek.
Cut that.
Gak apa-apa, Sulsel. Sulsel juga ceweknya bagus kok.
Yeah, Sulsel juga bagus. Tapi Sulut, like bro, those guys, bro, like gue, they beat the powerhouses of Jawa. Yes. Either they beat Jatim, Jateng. Did they play Jabar? I don't remember. They didn't, yeah.
They did not.
They
different,
okay,
group,
they still
different group.
They beat Jateng and Jatim, bro.
Yeah.
Like those guys are dogs, bro.
They are dogs though. And yeah, Sulut ya tim yang paling surprising sih. Yeah. untuk gue. Kalau Mike udah 40 menit, bentar lagi kita takutnya kalau 40 menit kelamaan ya. So we gotta cut it this, but hey, good luck.
Thank you, bro.
Good luck, man, with
good
your acting.
In America, bro.
Yeah, man, appreciate you. I need a lot of luck, man, in the US. I need all the luck that I can have. But hey, appreciate you though using my platform to share your story. Thank you for reaching out. My name Mike, you are reaching out. Apakah dia bisa kayak jelasin nggak nih gitu loh apa yang terjadi sama dia? I was really happy because I think this is what my platform for juga anyway. So good luck, man, with your acting career.
Again, I'm not talking crap about the fans. I'm just saying. I love the fans here. That's one thing that made me.
Orang ngerti kok yang mana kita ngomongin.
Too much. Again, jangan berlebihan if you're talking shit about someone. Yeah. Well, everyone has feelings. Itu aja.
Yeah, and then Mike, let us know if you have anything new.
Update us. I got you, bro. Come on, update us.
Maybe kalau mau pergi main ke IBL atau apa gitu kan kita nggak pernah tahu.
Dude, you're probably gonna be like the first person I tell.
Yeah, man. So Mike, good luck. Stay healthy, bro. Appreciate you, all love, and thank you guys for watching. Jangan lupa untuk follow lagi tuh. Siapa yang unfollow Instagram media?
Katanya banyak. Udah lah.
Katanya dari 34,000 turun jadi 28,000 katanya. Bah, jangan lupa follow lagi dong. And then apalagi ya, udah sih itu aja sih guys. Thank you yang sudah mau mendengarkan kita ngobrol-ngobrol selama 40 menit ini. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment, and we'll see you guys again on the next video.
Don't forget to subscribe too. Peace.
Peace out.